The president is coming to Indonesia and to Bali, specifically for the Bali Democracy Forum. This is a forum that was started by President Yudhoyono, President of Indonesia, in 2008, and this is his last chairing of the forum. For the past 7 years, the Philippine Embassy has recommended the President of the Philippines come and chair, co-chair the forum. And when President Aquino became president, it became more important for us to get him here because he is the son of two icons of democracy, and he himself has proven to be a person pursuing the democratization process or the democracy process of the Philippines in a way that we have not seen before. When the president comes to a country, it's usually for bilateral meetings, but this is exceptional. There will be no bilateral meetings, and it's in the bilateral meetings that the welfare of nationals of a specific country are discussed with the host country. That's not going to happen this time, except perhaps for the Filipinos to have pride that their president is coming to Indonesia for the fifth time in 3 years. So they feel that we have very important relations with Indonesia with that. The leaders portion, when that is the portion that is chaired by the president of Indonesia with a co-chair, with another president or prime minister co-chairing the meeting. And that is when the heads of state speak at the forum. Once all the heads of state have finished speaking, then the chairing of the forum is turned over to the foreign minister. And since the Philippines is the co-chair of the forum, then I would imagine that for the time that Secretary Del Rosario will be here, he will co-chair the meeting with the Foreign Minister of Indonesia, Martina Talegawa. Indonesia and the Philippines have a history of good relations from the time of the founding fathers, both of Indonesia, well, founding fathers of Indonesia, because our founding fathers date back to longer than Indonesia. Our founding fathers go back to the 19th century, whereas theirs go back to the middle of the 20th century. But the founding fathers had very good relations with our leaders and with our other officials. And I've seen that in written in history, in the autobiography of President Sukarno, for instance. But it's really hard for me to explain how that happened. And I always say when I ask, how is it that the Philippines and Indonesia have such close and warm relations? It's because our leaders set the tone. When they meet, they're automatically friends. Now, bilateral relations with Indonesia has gotten more active lately. This year, we had many events. One is the Joint Commission on Bilateral Cooperation, where we developed a plan of action. We signed a plan of action. It's like a scorecard for the activities that we have agreed upon for both countries to carry out. And then President Yudhoyono came in to the Philippines for a state visit when he went there for World Economic Forum. That visit is significant because it's a state visit. But more than that, it had an exceptional significance because that's when we signed the agreement on delimiting the exclusive economic zones of between the Philippines and Indonesia. That was an agreement that was 20 years in the making. 10,000 Filipinos in Indonesia, the number might have increased, but we have no record of that. We rely on immigration numbers because they don't register with us. In Bali, I know that they have gone up from 100 to about 100 to 200, but that was the case even the last time the president was here last year. I don't think there has been a significant increase in number. Now, what do they do? They have, I'm not sure, if you're asking Indonesia in general, and it applies to Bali too, they hold important positions. They have their general managers of hotels or certain companies. They have even have those who have their own companies here. Here in Bali, they do have that. Mga spa, mga iba-iba. Ang karamihan dito nga, sinabi ko, mga general manager, mga consultant, mga may-ari ng sarili nilang negosyo. Tapos, ang pinakamarami siguro ang professional dito ang mga teacher. Kasi nga, ang Indonesia nagbukas yan. Ginusto ng Indonesia na magkaroon ng maraming international school na kailangan sila ng mga English-speaking teachers. Ang kanilang piniling pagkuna ng mga English-speaking teachers ang Pilipinas. Ngayon, hindi ko alam kung anong naging epekto nun sa Pilipinas kasi maraming nagsilipatan dito. Pero alam ko marami pa rin tayong mga gurong magagaling sa atin. Hindi magbabago yan. Indonesia, Adipurna is the star, Bintang Star is the star of Indonesia. It's the highest award that's given by the government of the Republic of Indonesia to persons who have served the interest of Indonesia, greatness of Indonesia, the integrity and the viability and the greatness of Indonesia. It's hard for me to translate that, to understand how it is that a queen of a country could have done that, you know, for instance. Because the others receiving the award are royalty, are mostly royalty. The persons who have received this award, without a doubt, in the case of the presidents of Indonesia that received this award, yes, they have served the integrity, the viability, the greatness of their country. But the award is also given to foreign heads of state. And it has been given to the Queen of England, to the Queen of the Netherlands, the King of Thailand, the Sultan of two Sultans of Malaysia, the first King of Bahrain, Sultan of Oman. I mean, when you look at the list of foreigners who have received this award, they're mostly royalty. So, and this is the first time a Filipino is receiving the award. Now, to say to you that it's really for persons who serve the integrity and the viability and the greatness of Indonesia, that holds true for the presidents of Indonesia who received the award, and all presidents of Indonesia have received the award. But for foreigners, I think it's because they acknowledge the importance of Indonesia as a country, as a player in the region, as a player in the world, and that is what they are awarding. Well, the Bali Democracy Forum is the seventh of a series, and it's usually to take on issues that are relevant to democracy. Every year they have, I have to honestly admit, every year they have a theme. But in reality, the speakers pretty much say what they have to say, and it's usually how their democracy is functions in their country, and how their democracy is moving forward in cases of countries that are newly democratic countries. And this is a forum for them. I had said at one time, how long can this go on? It will, because there are many countries who want to be part of this forum. They want to be able to tell the world how far they have gone with their democracy. Now, what will the president do? When they co-chair, it's a simple, straightforward. He sits with the president of Indonesia. He makes his statements. He invites. He alternates with the president of Indonesia in inviting the other leaders to speak. I think they are. Yeah. This is something that I consciously do. In fact, I invite Filipinos to the embassy just to discuss this matter. And they're very pleased with how the Philippines has progressed economically, with the ratings that the Philippines is getting today, with the type of the level of investments that it's receiving. They're very pleased with other accomplishments. We've discussed the peace process, for instance, and they were very proud that the Philippines hosted the World Economic Forum. So certainly the Filipinos here are proud of the accomplishments of the Philippines, and we can credit President Aquino for this. I'd like to call on my fellow Filipinos, give the Philippines the support that it deserves. Be proud to be a Filipino. Learn to appreciate your culture and your heritage. Share it with your family. You will see that things will be different, and things can only get better, and we can do this if we work together to get there.
Thank you. Much better, much better.